Hello everyone, welcome to my virtual classroom. This is Dipto Narayan Chattopadhyay. Today I am going to discuss about art on Christmas. Christmas is celebrated on December 25th and both a sacred religious holiday and a worldwide cultural and commercial phenomenon. Christmas is a time for brotherly love, family, friends, good food, and presents. The Almighty Christ is a prevalent figure in the religion of Christianity, known as the Son of God. Both believers and non-believers recognize the cultural impact of the saintly man. The man was believed to have sacrificed himself on the cross for the good of mankind. His sacrifice absolved the world of their sins to allow believers to get into heaven. On December 25th, Christmas Day is one of the most festive Christian holidays, but any religion or beyond religion in most of the countries around the world, it celebrates humanity, celebrates Jesus' birth. The lack of literacy in pre-Renaissance and Renaissance times led the Catholic Church and wealthy merchants to commission a large number of painters to tell the story of origins of Christianity, the Christmas story in illustrative paintings. Artists and painters were in constant competition with each other to get the lucrative church contracts, which consequently led to some of the most stunning masterpieces in Western art. Today, I am going to tell the Christmas story in 10 of the most beautiful, famous, and legendary old master paintings. So, let's begin. In the year 1489, artist Botticelli made the painting called The Annunciation. The chapel of the Florentine monastery, Sestilo commissioned the Florentine Renaissance master Sandro Botticelli to paint the illustration that Archangel Gabriel visiting the Virgin Mary to deliver the news that she will give birth to the Son of God. You can see here her face so beautifully illustrates the emotional nature of the announcement she has just received. Second painting is artist Rembrandt's Dream of Joseph, done by 1645. The Flemish painter Rembrandt depicts Christ's earthly father who agrees to wed Mary when he discovers she is pregnant. In the Gospel of Matthew, God sends an angel to Joseph in a dream to explain the divine conception and instructs him to name the child Jesus. The third painting is by Hugo van der Hoes, Mary and Joseph on the way to Bethlehem in the year of 1475 to 1476. The painting, which is a part of the Portinari altarpiece and its oil on wood, shows Mary and Joseph traveling to Bethlehem. The Flemish artist beautifully illustrated Mary's advanced pregnancy by depicting the aging Joseph carefully guiding his wife down the steep and rocky mountain. Painting is presently placed in the Galleria degli Uffizi at Florence, Italy. Fourth painting is Peter Bruegel the Elder, The Census at Bethlehem in the year of 1566. set in a snowy winter scene, inspired by his native Flanders, Peter Bruegel the Elder depicts Mary and Joseph on their way to be registered in a census ordered by the Romans. Bruegel had a tendency to depict biblical events in a contemporary and local setting, which this painting illustrates perfectly. This painting by Oil on Panel and presently located at Royal Museum of Fine Arts of Belgium, Brussels. Fifth number painting is Nativity with St. Francis and St. Lawrence by artist Caravaggio in the year 1609. Caravaggio's last large-scale painting shows the Virgin Mary resting and gazing at the child she is just given birth to. The artist violates convention by placing an unnamed youth prominently in the foreground who looks towards an egging Joseph. Very sadly, this painting has been missing since 1969, when it was stolen from the Oratory of St. Lawrence in Palermo. Investigators believe the painting changed hands among the Sicilian Mafia in the decades following the robbery and may still be hidden. A replica was commissioned in 2015 and now hangs in the altar. The sixth number painting is Procession of the Magi, Eastern Wall by Bonazzo Gozzelli in the year of 1459 to 1461. Commissioned by the Medici family, the effective rulers of Florence, this multi-panel fresco located in the chapel of the Palazzo Medici Riccardi in Florence shows not the three kings, but a procession of 33 on the way to Bethlehem to praise the newborn baby Jesus. It portrays the biblical story for a contemporary audience. The artist painted the entire Medici clan in the Palazzo Medici Riccardi of Florence, Italy. Its walls are almost entirely covered by a famous circle of frescoes by the Renaissance master Bonazzo Gozzelli, painted around 1459 for the Medici family. The seventh one is Rubens, The Adoration of the Magi, year 1609 to 1610. This painting depicting the three kings worshipping and offering gifts to the newborn Son of God. This masterpiece is considered one of Rubens' most important works. The Baroque master was commissioned to paint the masterpiece by the Antwerp Town Council in 1609. And was presented to the Spanish ambassador as a peace offering at the end of the 12-year war in 1612. It was later acquired by Philip IV of Spain. The eighth number painting is by El Greco, The Adoration of the Shepherds, in the year between 1612 to 1614, completed by the Spanish Renaissance painter in the last year of his life. In the master's trademark distorted style, the artwork depicts the shepherds who came to Bethlehem to celebrate the birth of the newly born Son of God, together with the angels that circle above them. The ninth one is Workshop of Gwisen van der Weyden, Fly to Egypt, circa 1516. The angel of the Lord returns to Joseph in a dream to warn him about King Herod's plan to kill the newborn baby Jesus, assuming and dreaming him as a potential rival to his throne. The painting shows Joseph heeding the angel's advice and run away to Egypt with his young family. The painting presently placed the National Gallery, London. The 10th one is Raphael's Sistine Madonna. The Sistine Madonna, also called the Madonna di San Sisto, is an oil painting by the Italian master. The painting was commissioned in 1512 by Pope Julius II for the Church of San Sisto Piacenza. The artwork shows the Virgin Mary holding the Christ child with Saint Sixtus and Saint Barbara on the either side of her. The canvas was one of the last Madonnas painted by Raphael. The two cherubs on the bottom of the canvas are perhaps more famous than the rest of the composition. The painting presently located Gemelli Gallery, Alte Meister, Dresden. Do you know what is the largest Christmas gift in the history of the world? The answer is the Statue of Liberty. France gave the United States the Statue of Liberty on Christmas Day in 1886. The statue is 151 feet 1 inch high and weighed around 225 tons. Today, this much. Stay with me, keep learning, enhance yourself. We know this is a time for COVID. Whole world is suffering a lot, disease, depression and stress. But still, according to me, each and every problem is other way around an opportunity. In this loveliest of seasons, may you find many reasons for happiness. Best wishes for a Merry Christmas and a magnificent, safe, healthy New Year. See you in next video. Don't forget to give a thumbs up. Take care.